come before you, we thank
God, don't leave us alone. Don't leave us alone tonight.
We ask that you'll continue to abide.
We praise you, we honor you.
Yes, Lord, thank you.
I pray that you'll give that.
Glory to God.
Help him to deliver the message that you've given him, that some lost soul here tonight might be saved, and we might draw strength, Lord, we're trusting in you. We pray these things in your precious name.
Amen.
Amen.
Glad for him, aren't you?
Amen.
Glad that he's alive and well.
Yeah.
Lloyd quoted that scripture out of the, let me see, 13th chapter of Hebrews, 5th verse. If I'm not mistaken, he'd never leave me nor forsake me. Isaiah chapter 7 and verse 14, the Bible records there that it would be, the prophecy was given that they would be a virgin, bring forth a son.
Yep. Sure did.
And the prophet said there that that son would be called Emmanuel.
Yeah.
Emmanuel being interpreted means God with us.
Yes.
You think about that. God with us, Emmanuel. The apostle wrote there in Hebrews, he'll never leave us, never forsake us. Put those two together.
Lord.
That'll make a good meal right there. Praise the Lord. That's a good recipe. Glad for the Lord. I plan on, by the help of the Lord, reading out of the Psalmist, 139. Then I plan on reading out of Isaiah. So if you want, you young Bible readers, I'll give you a chance to get there. The 53rd chapter of Isaiah. Find that. And then the 139th chapter in Psalm. 139 in Psalm and chapter 53 in Isaiah. I'm going to do a lot of reading tonight. Probably more reading than I will be preaching. But boys, the Word of God can minister to us. Amen. The point I want to get across tonight. I'm glad that God provided a lamb, aren't you?
Yeah.
A lamb. I've been around a little bit, been around a lot of dead meat, not been around a whole lot of live meat, but my short time around live meat, every other animal. I heard a preacher preaching that in seminary they were showing over in some of the foreign lands, they were showing it. Videos of in their Bible study there, they were showing them about the animal sacrifices and how that they would offer up sacrifices unto God on altars. And it's been recorded for years. Now I'll read over into Isaiah there in just a little bit. But as strange as I am, and a lot of folks that probably say Richard Harold is probably one of the weirdest, strangest person they ever seen. But I'll tell you something that's ministered to me all week, Brother Ricky. And some of you laugh, but if you understand and listen to it, I had never listened to it. Don't know how that it come to my attention, but it's been on my mind. And I'll sing you a little bit. Mary had a little lamb. Little lamb, Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow. Said everywhere that Mary went, everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was what? Sure to go. Bless the Lord. Boy, I bet those YouTube people would get a kick out of that. Praise the Lord. Well, it went on to say, and I don't know all of it, but said followed her to school one day. Did you remember what the Word of God said in the 13th chapter of Hebrews? I'll never leave you, never forsake you. Aren't you glad for the Lamb of God? Followed her to school one day. School one day, followed her to school one day, which was against the rules. Boy, I tell you what, he gave us joy too, didn't he? Yeah, there were so and children laugh and play, laugh and play, laugh and play. Made the children laugh and play to see a lamb in school. Boy, you talking about what will get the hatred and the envy and the strife and the drugs, Toby, and the sin out of school. Get the lamb in school. Praise the Lord. I'm glad if we got him, he'll go everywhere that we go. I'll tell you what, all the apostles said in the 5th verse, in the 13th chapter, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. Be with you, Karen Barker, what even unto the end. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Now they say, my little bit of learning, they say that a lamb is different than any other animal when it's being ready and it's being prepared to be killed. Oh, bless the Lord. Praise the Lord. Don't want to get the cart before the horse. Lord, help me. I've been in beef slaughterhouses. Beef slaughterhouses, if you've never been there, I'll tell you what, a cow will sense a smell of blood. You know what a cow does when it senses that smell of blood? It begins to moan and begins to cry. I've been on farms before. I've been in a slaughterhouse. One of the saddest sounds that I've ever heard, it was to stand there in the slaughterhouse and listen to the cry of those cows that's waiting. Listen, in slaughterhouses they got chutes, and then they got walkways, they got paths, and I'll use it here for just a minute. In slaughterhouses they'll have gated areas. Some of you that's been there knows what I'm talking about. But they'll stand it. These cows will be in these gated areas. They'll be lined up. They'll go down about like a line at an amusement park or something. They'll go down that way. Then they'll go up this way. Oh, the Word of God says He would never leave us nor forsake us. Listen, the Word of God, listen, speaks of a place where they'll be weeping, wailing, and gnashing of teeth. Why? Because they know what is before them forever and ever. But listen to me. A cow, Ricky, will be there, and it'll sense that blood. They know that that blood is being taken and not given. And therefore, a fear will come upon them. Listen to me. A fear will come upon that cattle, and they'll begin to moan and cry. One of the most fearful sounds. Let's go over to Isaiah chapter 53. First, if you would. But the Bible said, who hath believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? Listen to me. But in a chicken house, listen, they'll squawk and they'll carry on. Toby, I've never seen a lamb killed. I'm going on what the Word of God said and what other people has told me. Said those that prepares lamb for people's tables said, listen, even though there's not a word that is spoken, and I know lambs can't talk, but listen, in their own language, said it don't matter, a lamb will open not its mouth. And said a lamb, listen, other animals will put up a struggle, and they'll put up a fight, and they fear death. But a lamb, listen, will stand in the calmest of ways and give itself and give its life when man wants to take it. No wonder the Word of God said he stood dumb as a lamb before the shears, and he opened not his mouth. Praise the Lord. He shall grow up before him as a tender plant. as a root out of dry ground. He hath no form, no comeliness. And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. We hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised and we esteemed him not. Look there in that third verse. Wouldn't everybody that say, for instance, you say, are you acquainted with Toby Little, Ricky Barker? Are you acquainted with Toby Little? You'd say, sure. And Ricky, I'd say, Ricky, what's acquainted mean? Ricky said, that means to know him. The Bible said that he was acquainted with grief. He knew grief, but he knew sorrow. Listen, he knew pain, lady. He knew death. That's why he gave himself as a lamb, both in the slaughter, that you and I would not have to go to that terrible place interpreted as hell.
Amen.
Surely he had borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. With his stripes we are healed. We all like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord hath laid upon him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed. He was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to slaughter, and as a sheep before his shears is dumb, so he openeth not his mouth.
Lord.
Listen, let's go over to Psalm 139 now. Listen, that becomes personal, Lee, when we make it personal. As I was telling you, that nursery rhyme, listen, the Lord will go with us. He'll go with us no matter where we are. I was thinking this week, Lee, when we make him real, we'll go into a restaurant, a sit-down restaurant, not a fast food restaurant, the restaurant, but you know, one of those where they serve you. You'll go in and you'll stand there and they'll have a sign there. Wait for the host or the hostess to seat you. It'll be our pleasure to seat you. They'll say, how many have you got? We'll say three or four, ever how many's in our party. Toby, well, I'll tell you what, we get wrapped up in Jesus, we'll make room for him. I wonder what they'd do if we'd walk in, there'd be three of us. They say, how many in the party? We'll say four. Yes, sir. Well, I only see three. Where's that other one? Is he coming later? No, he's here now. Yes, sir. He abides with me. He walks with me and he talks with me. Glad.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah. Everywhere that Mary went, the Lamb was sure to go. That's the way the Lord is.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Oh, Lord. 139 of Psalm. Oh Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. Boy, when we get ready to come to him, we examine him. We weigh this thing out. We check it out. Is this a life that I want to live? Little do we realize, before we was checking him out, Toby, he was checking us out. Even before we was conceived in the womb, the Son of God knew us, yes, sir, and he knew what he was made out of. Then we'll listen to the devil. Lee, and the devil will tell us that we're unfit and not good enough to be saved. But boy, I'm glad as David wrote here in the Psalms, he said, Lord, thou hast searched me and you know me. He said, thou knowest my doubt sitting and mine uprising. Thou understandest my thought afar off. Do you understand what that said? Lee, he knows when we sit down or we lay down, and he knows when we get up. Yeah, and he went on to say that he knows our thought afar off. He knows what we're planning. Yes, sir. Still loving us. He said, thou compassest my path and my lying down and art acquainted what? With all of my ways. Praise the Lord forever. I'm glad, listen, it was up to the Lord and not up to somebody else. Listen, there's a lot of folks, and I may be one of them. Folks might have looked at me and said, what a fine individual. Seemed like he's got a wonderful personality. Seemed like he's always got a smile on his face. Always in a good mood. Sound like somebody don't know him very well, don't it? Yeah, but if they was to get to know him, they know where that smile was. A frown appears sometimes. Yeah, and where that spirit of victory is, sometimes he walks through a valley. But the Lord was acquainted what? With my mood and my, oh, listen, church, that ought to make us shout. Lee, he knowed our ways and knowed all about us and still gave himself a ransom for our sins.
Amen. Yes.
We just don't get happy enough.
Praise the Lord.
Let's go.
For there is not a word in my tongue, but lo, O God, thou knowest it altogether.
Amen.
Yeah. For there is not a word in my tongue, but lo, O Lord, thou knowest it altogether.
Yes.
Thou hast beset me behind and before and done what? Laid thine hand upon me.
Yes.
Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain unto it. Whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me. Thy right hand shall what? Hold me. Bless his holy name. Boy, no wonder the apostle said, he'll never leave us. Never will he forsake thee. He'll be with us. What? Even unto the end. Everywhere that Mary went, Mary went, Mary went, everywhere that Mary went, what, the Lamb was sure to go. Praise the Lord forever. I'm glad that he's with us. I'm glad that he's before us. I'm glad that he's behind us. I'm glad that he's beside us. I'm glad that he's under us. I'm glad that he's over us. He overshadows us. And his right hand holds me. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yes, thank you.
In the Old Testament, when a right hand was laid on the younger, the sibling of the offspring of an individual, the right hand meant that that individual was getting a blessing.
Yeah.
That's what our Heavenly Father does to us. We're the offseed and the offspring of David. And Toby the psalmist said, if Karen, he laid his right hand upon me, that means that he's blessing me, giving me an inheritance to what? Listen, that only he can give and nobody can take it away. I'm glad for the Lord, aren't you?
Amen.
He said, and if I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be a light about me. Yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the night shineth as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike to thee. Yea, bless the Lord forever. Isn't that something? Lee, he don't need the light of this world. He don't need the sunlight. You and I, listen, we need light. And there's certain things. And even without these glasses here, I can see the numbers on this. And I can see that it's some. But I can put these glasses on. And I can see, boy, that God can see without glasses. And he can see without the light. I'm glad for him, aren't you? He said, yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the night shineth as the day, and the darkness and the light are both alike to thee. For thou hast possessed my reins, thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and what wonderfully made. Praise the Lord. We ought to feel like a model on a runway. Do you ever watch them? They'll just walk and so proud. Boy, Ricky, we ought to listen not to show off or not to think that we're something, but every time we ought to walk before a mirror and look at ourselves, myself, I'll say, man, I'm getting age spot and I've lost a little more hair. But the Bible said that we're fearfully and wonderfully made. Boy, we ought to walk up to the mirror and ought to say, boy, Richard Harold, you're a fine looking individual. Cause may God make you wonderful.
Yes, he did.
You mean you do that? I don't say I do that, but I ought to. I find the faults even with myself.
You're right. You're right.
They get mad if somebody else does.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Let's move on. That's the truth. I hit somebody's nerve right there. Yeah. We'll stand in front of the mirror and say, man, Johnny told me the other evening when I stopped over, he said, I believe your belly got bigger this week. Kind of insulted me. I'd already seen that, but I didn't get mad at me. Said, marvelous are thy works, that my soul knoweth right well. My substance was not hid from thee when I was made in secret and curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. Thine eyes did see my what? My substance. Yet, listen, being imperfect, and in thy book all my members were written, which in continuance were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them. How precious also are thy thoughts. What? Blessed be thy name. How precious also are thy thoughts unto me, O God. And how great is the sum of them.
Yes.
If I should count them, they are more in number than the sand. When I awake, I am still with thee. Surely thou wilt slay the wicked, O God. Depart from me, therefore, ye bloody men, for they speak against thee wickedly. Thine enemies take thy name in vain. Do not I hate them, O Lord, that hate thee, and am not I grieved with those that arise up against thee? I hate them with perfect hatred. I count them mine enemies.
Yes.
Search me, O God. Listen, can we say that tonight? Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. And see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. Praise the Lord forever. I'm glad for Jesus, aren't you? I'm glad that he's with me, that he makes a way for me. If you would, turn back over to Isaiah real quick. Let's read a verse and make sure I quoted it right. Isaiah chapter 7. Listen, I'm glad for the Lord, aren't you? I'm glad. In verse 10 of chapter 7, of Isaiah said, moreover, the Lord spake again unto Ahaz, saying, ask thee a sign of the Lord thy God. Ask it either in the depth or in the height above. But Ahaz said, I will not ask, neither will I tempt the Lord. And he said, hear ye now, house of David, is it a small thing for you to weary men, but ye weary my God also? For listen, he said, therefore the Lord himself, not telling nobody else, Lee, listen, the word said that I've quoted about 15 times already in Hebrews, will never leave us nor forsake us. Be with us even unto the end. He said, the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin what shall conceive, praise the Lord, and bear a son, and shall call his name what? Emmanuel. Well, since we're there, let's go to Matthew, I believe, chapter 2, if we would. Yes, chapter 1. And the Bible said, listen, if I'm right, y'all pray for me, but make sure that I'm where I need to be, and God is leading me, and will be just exactly what the Lord wants. Listen, verse 23, you remember what we read there in Isaiah chapter 14, verse 7, but in 23 of chapter 1 in Matthew, listen, said, behold, a virgin shall be with child and shall bring forth a son. They shall call his name what? Emmanuel. And it went on to say, and which being interpreted is what? God with us. Stand if you would. Mary had a little lamb, little lamb, little lamb. Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow. Lee, I'll tell you what, he was a perfect lamb for a perfect and imperfect sacrifice. A perfect lamb without spot, without blemish, but he had to sacrifice his life and give his blood for wretched sinners such as us.
Lord, bless you, Richard. God bless you.
Never leave us.
God bless you.
Never forsake us.
No.
Be with us.
Always.
Even unto the end.
Yes.
The psalmist said there in 139, he said, though I take the wings of the morning, thou art there.
Yes.
The psalmist said there, though I make my bed in hell, thou art with me. Church,
Lord,
he'll never leave us,
no,
never forsake us.
No.
He'll be with us even
Amen.
To the end of the world.
Lord.
Songwriter wrote the song, said he promised never to leave me.
No.
Never to leave me alone.
Oh.
He could have given him a name.
Come on, Richard.
Lee. That could have meant heaven's very best.
Yes.
And it could have been true.
Yes, yes.
He could have given him a name that meant never been anyone like this before.
Right.
It would have been true.
Yes, right.
But he told the prophet, his name shall be called Emmanuel.
Yes.
Meaning God with us.
Yes. Yes.
Toby, in the bad times.
Yes.
In the good times.
Oh, yeah.
This week I visited an individual in the hospital. And I've known him probably just about all of my life. This person was always, I interpreting as being tough, hard, strong.
Come on, Richard.
Didn't need nobody else, didn't need to lean on nobody else. After the diagnosis from the doctors,
oh, yeah.
his countenance, his personality, his air was completely different. A person that was so tough, probably within the first three words out of my mouth, tears began to roll down his face. And an individual that never associated himself with the church or people that prayed, out of those same lips, Toby said, "Please pray." Said it over and over again. With a tube down his throat and with a trach, couldn't make an audible sound, but he made sure he spelled it out with his lips.
Amen.
Tears running down his face.
Yes.
You know what, Lee? If we would live 60, 70 years and never acknowledge the name of Jesus.
Yes. Come on, Richard.
We serve a loving God that's not got the spirit like we do.
Oh.
See, you didn't like me before. Don't call on me now.
Yes, right.
But that loving Lamb stood there. No matter what the hurt had been caused, the name that had been blasphemed for years,
yes.
the name that had been spoken in vain for many, many years. Is there presenting himself in love,
yes,
and mercy.
Lord.
Emmanuel, meaning God with us. Isn't that special?
That is special.
Perfect place to be.
Yes.
Saved is right here in this church house.
Yes.
I'm glad that he's not confined to these four walls. Now, I'll not embarrass Cody, but he's a good example. And I'm sure he don't mind me sharing this with the church. Sunday night he texted Jeremy in so many words, I don't know word for word, but Jeremy shared with me. Cody said, I should have been saved. Church service was over. Toby, I don't care how urgent the request is. I don't care how broke you are.
Come on, come on.
Where do you bank, Toby?
BB&T.
How long you been with them, Toby?
16
years? Somewhere in that area, that's good enough. You think you got a pretty good credit record down there? Pretty good standing with them? Yeah, paid his bills on time. If he borrowed money, signed on the dotted line, paid his money back. They locked the door, say, at 5 o'clock. Toby been with them 16 years, abided by the rules, banked with them, been a good customer.
Come on.
They locked the doors at 5. Toby's standing there 30 seconds after, beating on the door. Hey, I'm a customer. I've been your customer 15, 16 years. I'm a good customer. Check the books. I need to get in there. I need to check cash. I'm just on my way from home from work. My wife called and I got to stop and get the baby some medicine. Mr. Little, I remember seeing you, but buddy, come back at 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm glad the Lord's not like that, aren't you? When we turn out the lights in this building, set the alarm and lock the doors, jack the call of God, he's still wooing lost men and women, and he'll meet them where they meet their conditions.
Amen.
Cody wanted to come to this altar. He felt the call of God. But like so many of us, he resisted.
Oh, yeah.
But as he went home, the call of God was still there. I don't know the ball field, but them boys said that they got down on the pitcher's mound. And Jesus, they didn't build that place for sinners to be saved. They built that place for a pitcher to stand. Buddy, I'll tell you what, it don't matter, Zach. Nope. If it's on a toilet seat, wherever we meet the conditions of God and we see that we need Him more than anything else, all of heaven will stand still. He'll come down to our rescue and save our lost soul.
Yeah, praise the Lord. Amen.
And the prophet said, His name shall be called Emmanuel, meaning God with us.
Oh, yes.
Every head bowed, every eye closed. Sinner, God's with you. He's walking right by your side. I told Porky Monday evening, I said, Porky, if you only realized in the last few months since you've come under conviction, that desire to be a Christian has come upon your heart. The devil purposed stronger than any other time in your life that he had to kill you.
Oh, yeah.
That he had to get you out of this life lost and undone without a Savior.
Oh, yeah.
Day after day, night after night, God put watchful angels around about you to protect you, that you could be saved. Sinner, God's with you tonight. But this word of God teaches us that the Spirit of God will not strive with men always.
You're right.
One of these days, I've seen it. It's a sad situation in my life. I've seen men and women resist the call of God. Then after a while, that call leaves. Knock at their heart's door, no longer exists. God's with you tonight. Will you acknowledge Him as your Lord and as your Savior? Say, save me, Lord. Porky, Chris, Cody, and our dear sister that's here tonight that's just been saved not even a week yet, or a week today, would say, friend, it didn't take an educated or rehearsed prayer, but all it took was me saying, Lord, I need you, and I'm sorry. And that's when hell left. And heaven came down.
Oh, yeah.
Would you slip out of your seat right now? Would you slip out of your seat? Sing that chorus, Zach.
Did I mention that I loved Him, that I would spend the glory?
Listen, hear what it says.
When I could see no way.
Makes a way.
He makes a way.
You say, ain't no way I can be saved. You can't, but if you'll give it to Him, He'll make a way.
Did I mention He's been faithful through every promise He's ever made me? I love Him, and that's all I want to say.
Every head bowed, every eye closed, and the Christians praying. Preacher, I'm here tonight and I'm lost. If I was to die right now, I know I would go to hell and I don't want to go there. This is your first time here. You've never heard me say that. We've never made it a practice, and we won't make it a practice of trying to embarrass anybody or drag people to an altar. I could get some of these guys, I could take these guys here on the front seats. We could come back and manhandle you, get you up here at the altar, twist your arm, pull your hair, and make you say, Jesus, save me. Forgive me my sins. If we forced you to do it, it would not work. But the Spirit of God's calling you. I want you to slip out of your seat right now. Come down to this altar. Come on. Come right now. Come on. God with us. That's what Emmanuel. He's with you tonight. He knows you. You say, preacher, I can't be saved. Why in the world is he calling you and he knows you? If he didn't care about you, he wouldn't be calling you. He knows more about you than you know about yourself. The psalmist said he knows your thoughts afar off. He knows what you're going to be thinking tomorrow. But tonight he wants to save you. Come on, right now. Come on.
Thank you.
Come on, don't put it off no longer. Well, I'm going to, don't you wait. Don't you wait. You can't afford to wait. This could be your last call. Your last opportunity. Not trying to scare you, but let's face reality. Let's face reality. You're under conviction. You say, yes, preacher, I'm under conviction. Every head bowed and every eye is closed. Could you slip your hand up and say, preacher, nobody's looking around except you and the Lord. Preacher, God's dealing with me. Could you slip your hand up? Say, God's dealing with me. God knows your heart. The devil's aware of that. He knows that the Lord's speaking to you. He gonna do his best to kill you. When life goes out of your body, there's no other chance for you to be saved. But the word teaches us where there's life, there is hope. But while you've got breath in your body, why don't you come right now and give your heart and life to Jesus? I'm going to sing the chorus one more time and give you an opportunity to pray. Sing it, Zach.
Did I mention that I love you, that I am worshiping the glory when I can see the way? I love him, and that's all I want to say.
That's the invitation tonight. You may be seated.